Remain standing and join us in singing our national anthem, which will be played by the Mount Everett Wind Ensemble and sung by Ariana Jackson.
Thank you.
be seated. Good morning. On behalf of the school committee, administration, and staff of the Southern Berkshire Regional School District, welcome to the commencement exercises for the class of 2022. Our guests and colleagues joining me on stage, our school committee members, Chairperson Jane Burke, Vice Chairperson Art Pataki, H. Dennis Sears, Bonnie Silvers. Also on stage are Dr. Beth Regabuto, Superintendent of Schools, Julie Dolan, Director of Curriculum Instruction, Douglas DePondi, Assistant Principal, Dawn Estes-Dobb, Graduation Coordinator and School Counselor, Lou Randall, School Counselor, Neil Barberry, Graduation Coordinator, Courtney English, and the Mount Everett Golden Eagle Band. And I am Jesse Carpenter, Principal of Mount Everett Regional School. So I'm fired up for our return to Tanglewood and having graduation back here. As I told the kids the other day at the award ceremony, 30 years ago, I sat where they sat here at Tanglewood for my high school graduation from Mount Everett with my whole life in front of me. It's worked out pretty well. 5 years ago, in my former life as a middle school English teacher, I had the privilege of speaking at your 8th grade recognition night. It was my job to give words of wisdom that would help you enter high school ready to be a successful student. Do you remember what I told you? I'm not offended. I don't remember either. When I became principal 3 years ago, that seemed like 25 years ago. But I know that whatever I said is inspirational and changed your life. Now it's my job today to provide you with wisdom that will help you take the next step in your post-secondary school life. We all know that the last few years have been challenging. There have been a lot of things that have been frustrating during the pandemic. Granted, this year has been a lot better as we have returned to most of our activities and traditions. I so appreciate the leadership of Dr. Regabuto, school committee chairperson Jen Burke, and the rest of the school committee as they have navigated this pandemic. They were instrumental in allowing our students to return to athletics, theater productions, field trips, and traditions like the prom and senior trip. Thank you very much to all of you. I'm sure that many of you are like me and over the last 3 years have begun to question a lot of things. Recently, I've spent a lot of time thinking about things that I do not understand or seem to have no logical answers. There are some little things I've been confused about recently, like why are there a billion caterpillars all over the place? Earlier this week, my back of my house looked like a horror movie. My wife was so disgusted, she took out the leaf blower and started blowing the things off the house, and they returned 47 seconds later. Another thing that confuses me is why all our kids today are glued to their phones 24 hours a day. I don't understand when I see kids at school sitting next to each other and texting, why they're texting each other and not actually speaking words. And don't even get me started about TikTok. Every day, I see a different group of kids set their phones up on the windowsill, do some silly dance, post it to TikTok. I was so happy that we had a normal prom until we started making TikTok videos, which people shared with me afterwards. You know who you are who did that. It makes me glad that cell phones didn't exist when I was a kid. But there are also bigger things that I've begun to question that have no logical answers to. The constant senseless violence all around our country continues to bother me. Things that have happened recently in the last few months in Buffalo, Texas, and Chicago have no explanation. At what point do we as a nation come together to end the senseless violence in school and tragedies that are a result of racism and the lack of tolerance? Another thing that we are all dealing with and trying to understand is COVID. 3 years into this, there are still so many unanswered questions. Clearly, this is going to be part of our lives moving forward. How do we protect ourselves and our loved ones as we go about our daily lives? As I think about all that, There's some things that still make sense, whether we're in a pandemic or not. And one thing that does make sense is the recipe for success. My bit of wisdom for you today is keep chopping wood. Pay attention. I don't want this to be like 5 years from now, where you're like, I have no idea what he said. When I was a ball coach here at Mount Everett, I used to tell my teams to keep chopping wood whenever we were struggling. The idea that if you keep swinging the axe, the tree will eventually fall, make for a good analogy for my players. This message is one that I use at home with my own children. Sometimes life is hard and we feel like giving up, but we keep chopping wood and the tree will eventually fall. As you move forward to the next stage of your life, whether it be going to college, joining the workforce, or joining the military, don't let obstacles stop you. Have the grit and perseverance necessary to overcome all adversity in your life. If the last 3 years have shown us anything, it is that we are stronger than we could ever think we could be. Keep chopping wood and that tree will fall. Lastly, a few years ago, one of our valedictorians said, once an eagle, always an eagle. Always remember this as we say goodbye to another senior class. Many of you have been with us on the Sheffield campus since you were 6 months old in our child care program. You're an eagle for life. Remember, you have people in our school building who love you and care about you. If you need anything this summer in the future, do not be afraid to come back and ask for help. Congratulations and good luck. The first speaker on our program will be the class salutatorian Grace Maycook to deliver our welcome address.
My pleasure to welcome you to the graduation ceremony of Mount Everett's class of 2022. I want to start by thanking everyone who came out to support us today. Faculty and staff, family, friends, administration, school committee members, and anyone else who's been there to support this class along the way. I want to tell you a brief story this morning. Some of you might recognize it from a variety of places, including Mr. Antle's 8th grade science classroom, and others simply because it is a famous parable. Once upon a time, there was an old farmer who bought a prized horse, but shortly after, the horse ran away. Everyone in the village attempted to console the man and proclaimed his bad luck. However, the farmer simply replied, "Good news, bad news, who knows?" The next day, the horse returned and brought with it 5 wild horses. All of the village rejoiced and praised the man for his good fortune. However, the farmer simply replied, "Good news, bad news, who knows?" On the following day, the old man's son was out riding one of the wild horses and was thrown off, badly breaking his leg. The village showed up to support him and expressed concern over the bad luck. However, the farmer simply replied, "Good news, bad news, who knows?" A week later, war broke out in the country, and the emperor's generals came to take every able-bodied young man to help fight. Having a broken leg, the farmer's son was passed over. "That is very good luck," the village exclaimed. Now at this point, I'm sure you can guess the farmer's reply. "Good news, bad news, who knows?" And the parable continues on in this fashion. Some event happens, the village initially reacts, and the wise farmer declares that one cannot possibly predict the future. The first lesson from the parable is the farmer's outlook on life. Do not be so quick to judge a situation. What might appear as the worst possible outcome could lead to a highly valuable opportunity, but you will never know until after the fact. Instead of assuming an immediate impact, we must pause and reflect later on how our past has led us to our present, and our present will always lead us to an unexpected future. The second and less obvious lesson is that of the village. While they do embody quick judgment of a situation and may appear ignorant to readers, they are also always there for the old man. Some versions of the story present the village as a neighbor or friend. I think that the village is all of you, sitting out in the audience today, our community. You are the responsive village that has always encouraged the graduates sitting next to me today, and will continue to for years to come. On behalf of the Mount Everett class of 2022, thank you. And to my fellow classmates, remember that you will always have a community to back you up, and trust that life will lead you where you're meant to go. Congratulations and thank you.
Thank you, Grace, that was great. Neil Barbary and Donna Sisdal will now announce the recipient of a few awards.
Morning. The Massachusetts Secondary School Administrators Association Student Achievement Award is given to a student who has made a positive difference in the school community. The award goes to Rochelle Wirth. Principal's Leadership Award is presented to the senior who has demonstrated the ability to combine academic excellence and leadership in school and community activities. The award goes to Nadia Mako.
Welcome School Committee Chairperson Jane Burke to the podium to announce our two highest ranking students and say a few words. Would Dr. Beth Regabuto please join me at the awards table.
Class of 2022 who have been named this year's salutatorian and valedictorian. Each of these students has devoted countless long hours and a tremendous amount of hard work and dedication to their studies at Mount Everett to receive this time-honored recognition. The salutatorian of the graduating class is the student who has achieved the second highest grade point average. And this year's salutatorian is Grace Mako. Of the graduating class is the student who has achieved the highest weighted grade point average. This year's valedictorian is Nadia Mako. Comment, having been with the district since 1983, there are a lot of Maycooks who have been congratulated. And you wonder about what's going on in the culture of their family that is making this possible. And I want to give the Maycook family a hand. That it says the school committee remarks because for my last three speeches I misunderstood this and I thought they were my remarks. So this year you will be getting the true school committee remarks because on Thursday night I collected them and here they come. And I know that you can't hear as well as they can, these remarks are for you. I do first want to thank our communities, our administration, our school committee, our teachers for the amazing amount of support they gave us on the school committee so that we could do the best for our students, which is why we're there. So, are you ready? Okay, so first I'm supposed to make it not too long. Here's the first thing. Congratulations on making it through high school despite the challenges and disappointments of the pandemic for more than half of your 4 years. We did the best we could to make you safe and not too limited. We are proud of you for who you are as people. You have pulled together, supported each other, learned from each other, and persevered. You exemplify this district's motto, which is SBRSD cares. And we hear about that from the public wherever you go, that you show character beyond most teenagers that they meet. Your actions have shown how much you care about each other, the local community, and the world. You accept everyone unconditionally. You volunteer in the community, and you advocate for change. And we celebrate that in you. We have been impressed by those of you who have come to speak to us because we see that you are both athletes, performers, volunteers, and academic seekers. You're amazing. Now, because we love you, we can't help but give you some advice on top of congratulating you for who you are. So here is the advice. Going out into the larger world, you're bound to confront fear. It's okay. You have what it takes to overcome it. When you see a problem, be the solution. Do something about it. Embrace new people, be a global citizen, and continue to treat others well, and don't give up. Finally, I have what I'm giving to my grandson for his preschool graduation before going into kindergarten. And I have to read you the last two pages because I think they apply to you. As you go out on the voyage to the future, no matter what happens, you know that you are loved. And you are ready. Go ahead. Be you. Be very, very you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Jane. That was great. Now, Superintendent Dr. Beth Redibuto would like to say a few words and confer the Massachusetts Superintendent's Certificate for Academic Excellence.
Well, he said I can do whatever I want. That never is something that anybody says to me. So I'll say a few words and then I'll give the award. Good morning to members of the class of 2022, families and friends, administration, faculty and staff, and members of the school committee. First, let me say to the class of 2022, congratulations on all your wonderful accomplishments, and thank you for letting me be part of your special day. Today, we gather to celebrate the individual and collective achievements of the class of 2022. The students before me have much to celebrate, as they have met all local and state graduation requirements, and are well prepared as they continue their journey into the workforce, military service, and higher education. I would like to take a moment to give a special thank you, oh dear, to those going into military service on behalf of all of us. Please stand and be recognized. As I was thinking about what I was going to say, I realized that I would have a very short amount of time to impart some meaningful words of wisdom to the graduates who today are beginning the next chapter of their lives, pushing forward into a post-pandemic world, and likely struggling at the notion of what their life will be like next. These amazing young people are faced with their own personal struggles, managing their fears, imagining what's possible, and forging into the unknown. And I've only got a few minutes to congratulate them on their accomplishments, encourage them to be courageous, and challenge them to do incredible things with their lives. So in these fleeting moments, what should I share with you? I came across this quote by Zig Ziglar a while ago, and I thought it was good advice. The three C's of life, choices, chances, changes. You must make the choice to take a chance if you want anything in life to change. I want you to know there are going to be hard times, difficult circumstances, and temporary setbacks in your life. But I also want you to remember that they don't define you, but rather the choices you make during these times and what you do with these life lessons is what's really important. One of my mentors, to whom I will always be grateful, shared these wise words with me as I was going through a very difficult time. She said, "It is in these moments you need to know who you are and what you believe." She said, "What are your core values and what are your non-negotiables? And once you know, make the choice to act in accordance with those core values, as they will be the foundation that gets you through. We are confident that you have the strength of character and the ability to make the choices as to what you stand for as you enter this next chapter in your life. These last several years have reminded us that life is a gift, an invaluable, priceless gift that we should not take for granted. This special community's gift to you was to create a safe and engaging learning environment that encouraged you all to take chances throughout your school journey, knowing that we were here to catch you if you fell, to push you even when you weren't sure you could do it, and to celebrate all of your successes. My hope is that you will take chances every day, boldly and passionately, finding gratitude for all you have and being open to all possibilities. Whether we are ready or not, things change, we change, the world changes. What matters is how ready you are for these moments of surprise, those that challenge us, and those of opportunity. I hope that you will confidently walk through these doors when they open, or that you'll have the courage and purpose to open it yourselves. And if necessary, you have the bravery to tear down walls, whether internal or external, as we are counting on you as the future. You must make the choice to take a chance if you want anything in life to change. Class of 2022, I'm proud of you and proud to be your superintendent. Congratulations and best wishes as you start your lives as the newest graduates of Mount Everett Regional School. Always know that you are forever members of our school community and that each one of you has changed us for the better. Thank you. I now have the pleasure of giving the Superintendent's Award. The Massachusetts Association of School Superintendents Certificate of Academic Excellence Award. They certainly made that a mouthful. This award was designed by the Massachusetts Association of School Superintendents to honor a high school senior who has distinguished herself in pursuit of excellence during her high school career. It is my great pleasure to share that I have selected Nadia May Cook.
Thank you, Dr. Rodolito, that was great. All right, we'll move this thing right along. It is now with great pleasure that I introduce class valedictorian, Nadia May Cook, to deliver the honors speech.
morning to everyone gathered here to commemorate our graduation. I'd like to begin by reading a poem by Robert Frost, titled, Nothing Gold Can Stain. Nature's first green is gold, her hardest hue to hold. Her early leaves a flower, but only so an hour. Then leaf subsides to leaf, so Eden sank to grief. So dawn goes down today, nothing gold can stain. In the most literal, but also pessimistic sense of this poem, the sunrise period of our life is over. I know we've all had our fair share of having to be an adult these past 4 years, and I'm confident we're already living life past dawn. But that doesn't mean we have to tarnish. Some of you may remember this poem from a novel we read in seventh grade English, The Outsiders by S.E. Hinton. In the story, mentor character Johnny saves his friend Ponyboy from being drowned, but kills the rival gang member who is trying to drown him. While running from this difficult situation, he happens upon a burning building and risks his own life to save the school children inside, leaving him with critical injuries. He is forced to grow up quickly, to say the least. None of us can relate to Johnny's situation exactly, but regardless, we've had our own share of adversities that have forced us to grow up, that have made us feel like the gold is wearing off. It is all too easy to see what Frost is saying, and it would be easy to succumb to the notion that the golden hour of our lives is over. However, I'm going to take after Johnny, who in an act of defiance, with his dying breath, told Ponyboy to stay gold. Yesterday, as the class of 2022, we signed a new mural at the entrance of the school, which reminds those who enter to stay gold. It's short, it's sweet, and it's school-spirited, but it also contains an invaluable lesson for us today, which I hope we keep with us for the rest of our lives. As I've mentioned, we've already had to grow up in many ways. We can drive, we've got jobs, we've had duties to our families, and the taste of many freedoms. But as we grow to be productive members of society, let us stay young in spirit. Stay fun, stay humble, stay silly. We have the rest of our lives for the world to try to wear us down. But in the meantime, drink the Dr. Pepper, wear the rubber duck hat, buy the Pokemon Converse, and don't be afraid to keep Piglet in your backpack. Make your inner first grade self happy. More importantly though, make your inner first grade self proud. The you from 12 years ago is proud that you were up here on the stage. Make sure that everything you do, everything you say, would still make them proud. Be the one who starts the conversation. Pick up the litter, write the thank you card, and put your all into everything you do. Stay open-minded, stay vulnerable, stay curious. Above all, stay honest. If you constantly pursue the truth, then you will always remain gold. It may be considered ironic or even naive of me to seemingly encourage continuity on this day, which marks the most considerable change in our lives so far. I'll begrudgingly acknowledge that we can no longer stay Mount Everest students. We are leaving the blue and gold, and we are going on to do more good things. Whether we have new school colors or work or military uniforms, I'm confident that we will wear them just as well. However, we first owe a thanks to the people who have prepared us. Were it not for our teachers, our parents, and each other, we would not be ready to move on. And so we'd have a duty to give back to our community. I challenge you this summer, this year, and for the rest of your lives to find ways to provide for someone else what you were given, to love Mount Everett and to love this community which has loved you. As we go on to live out our lives, remember, we are built on a foundation of gold. Let it shine through. Johnny gives one final piece of advice to Pony Boy, which is perhaps most important for us all today. You still have a lot of time to make yourself be what you want. There's still a lot of good in the world. Thing is, we have to be the good in the world. The first graders who watched us march around the school yesterday fully believe that us big kids, us now young adults, are the good in the world. Prove them right. We've still got time, but now is the moment to begin being the best version of yourself. Class of 2022, I wish you all very good lives. Stay gold.
Thank you, Nadia. That was excellent. Now, The Hobbits by Johann Demey and arranged by Paul Lavender was chosen by the senior band members who will join their classmates in their last performance as members of the Mount Everett Golden Eagle Band, directed by Courtney English.
Thank you.
Division Golden Eagle Band. At this time, the school committee of the Southern Berkshire Regional School District takes pride in awarding diplomas to the class of 2022. Jane Burke, chairperson of the school committee, assisted by Superintendent Dr. Beth Redibuto and Assistant Principal Doug DePonde, will join me in making the presentations.
Graduates come forth and be recognized. Alexandria Elizabeth Anderson. Alexia Jade Lavalla. Stacy Lynn Halleck. Brianna Ray Dunn. Riley Jade Davis Gagnon. Jasmine Marie French. Reese Thomas Mullen. Hunter Curtis DeGrenier. Ashton John Aloisi. Tyler William Duquette. Victoria Marie Gilmore. Huda Ngoi Nkulu. Mariah Claire Rogers. Elena Lee Donsbog. Alexandria Grace Tamasha. Emma Lucy Stewart. Marina Elizabeth Kirimpasi. Catherine Marie Nagy. Alexis Kirsten Atwood. Jason Richard Ham Jr. Connor Matthew Boardman. Elizabeth Ann McMeekin. Justin Douglas Clark Foster. Benjamin Monteleone. Benjamin Thomas Shannon. Kayla Ashley Martell. Anthony Cole Rahilly. Ariana Victoria Jackson. Will Worth. Anthony Thomas Emmerling. Armando Batista Cruz. Isaiah Quinn Neske. Logan James Reynolds. Michael Jeffrey Norse. Vaughn Sparhawk Marchone. Coda Andrew Rinaldi. Justin Thomas Wall. Travis James McLaughlin. Micah G. Ketchin. Colin Gregory Thorpe. Rochelle May Worth. Tyler West Smith. Nadia Denise Tommaso Maker. Grace Ann Claire Maker.
anybody's wondering why the handshakes are so awkward, you would think after the first 2 years of not being able to shake anybody's hand, we could have just done it normally. But they gave me these little dye, which are microscopic. And so when you leave, carefully don't trip on any of them, because I didn't even realize what it was for the first 3 or 4.
Mark, you always count on us.
I get the analogy. I appreciate it. That was meaningful. I'd also like you to know that when I rolled the dice, most of them came up 4s, which is the number I wore when I coached ball here. So, I would now like to introduce the officers of the class of 2022. President Grace Maycook. Vice President Nadia Maycook. Secretary Micah Ketchin. Treasurer Tyler Smith. Student Representative Michael Norse. Gold Captain Benjamin Monteleone. And Gold Captain Luna Nagoy and Kulu. Grace Maycook, would you please come down to lead the class in the tassel ritual? Thank a couple people. Coming back to Tanglewood is a big operation for us. I'd like to thank Neil Barber and Don Estes Dobb, who are our graduation coordinators. I'd like to thank Lou Randall and Beth Hall in the guidance department for their help in putting everything together. I also want to make sure our graduates are aware that they would not be sitting up here today if it were not for the love and support of the people sitting out with all of you. Please join me in giving your friends and family a hand. In closing, on behalf of the staff, faculty, administration, I would like to offer to the class of 2022 a wish for happiness, good health, and success in the future. I'd also like to say our last gift to all of you was a graduation that took exactly 1 hour. I would ask that all of you please remain at your seats as the Mount Everett faculty leads our recessional and forms a receiving line at the rear of the shed. Thank you all for coming. Have a lovely afternoon.